Welcome, everybody. In this episode over here, we're going to be talking about the real Godfather. The one that everybody's been forgetting about, you see, and not paying their taxes to. You know, in Matthew 13 over here, when the angels are coming around to reap the harvest, you see. When the Godfather's lieutenants start coming back into this world, and all the people here that forgot about the Godfather, who me and Kim. This is what we're going to understand over here. What is the Godfather? Oh, Godfather, Godfather, oh, Godfather. What these grease balls in the world over here have turned around and provided the real Godfather over here. So I'm going to be talking like a little bit of a Jersey Shore guy, because that's kind of my blood as well, too. I'm just a Sicilian anyways. That's why I hearkened to the Godfather at first, you know? So the Godfather, what is the Godfather anyways? As you can see, it's a mafia, right? It's an organization over here. Not only that, though, but it's a secret organization. Eh, not everybody can get in to the mafia of the Godfather. That's why there's also a process over here. Comes sort of like an initiation, you know what I mean? Like a rebirth over here. You got to be reborn in the spirit over here, and you got to make sure you're worshiping the Godfather. He's looking for his true worshippers, you know? John 4, verse 21 over there, 22, whatever it is over here. God seeking its true worshipers because he's the spirit of God, you know. So this organization, you see, this organization that everybody's forgot about, God's secret mafia, the organization. We're going to get a little bit to the earthlings over here, why they have a mafia to begin with. Well, in the world over here, we can't get all the things that we want, you see. So that guy over there, he's got something I want. And guess what? I'm a lot stronger than him. Fuck him. I'm just going to take it. And that's what we do. We get a bunch of us. We say, fuck this fucking guy. He's weak. He's got a fucking family. He's scared because I take care of his kids, you see. This is all material conditions. And all of a sudden over here, we're just trying to make a living out of these pathetic material conditions. So we run up over here. We steal this fucking guy's shit, that fucking guy's shit, any fucking guy's shit. Doesn't matter who it is. We steal from everybody. Don't matter who it is. We're not a respecter of persons over here in our organization. It's just the same thing as God. You know, he ain't no respecter of persons if you ever catch the drift of how Kobe Bryant is falling out of airplanes. Yeah, he ain't a respecter of persons either, the Godfather. So we gotta understand a little bit about this Godfather over here and his secret organization. So these pukes out in the world over here, they want to take from everybody else. You see, all the things that I don't have. So yeah, they get their little clicks, they steal. And then here's the point of this mafia. Here's the point of this Godfather. He has fear, and he's got a lot of power, you see. And that's what he collects in the world. He collects his little lieutenants, and then they go around in the neighborhood, and they say, listen, if you don't want us fucking around with you, you pay me. You understand? We give you protection over here. If you don't, we're going to fuck you up. It's that simple. Now fuck you and pay me. If not, go fuck yourself. We're going to bust your fucking head open. It's the same thing with God. When we go to the Godfather, what do we go to the Godfather for? Eh? Because he's got all the power. Oh, not only that, but everybody's terrified of the Godfather up in heaven. Hallowed be thy name. Everybody's terrified. But the thing in this world, you see, they don't really know the Godfather because he's so much hidden. He's so secret, just like Don Corleone. They don't really know the Godfather, but they know the ones that really know Godfather, you see. Now, every time they go into the organization, these fucking guys, right? Every time now, let's say if I got a problem with somebody. Why do we go to Godfather? Oh, why don't we go to somebody? Why don't we go to the police over here? Oh, because the fucking police don't give a shit about me. Ain't gonna help me. You see that there? Why don't I just go to my government? Oh, you think the government's gonna help me? I'm just a little fucking asshole that pays my taxes, you see? I have to go to the secret mafia to have my personal affairs handed to, you know, just like God. Why do we go to God here? Because he's our personal Godfather. We go to him because he's going to handle the things for us. Why? Why do we go to Godfather? Because he's got the power, you see. Why can't I go with my worldly problems over there to the fucking police department because some asshole's harassing me, eh? Because they won't do nothing about it. They got no power. You see that? So we go to the Godfather. Say, Godfather, there's this fucking guy over here causing me stress. I need you to take care of him. Godfather might not like that, you see, because you're not a part of his clique. He's like, I don't know who the fuck you are. Who the fuck are you anyways to ask me a favor? I don't know you. You don't know me. Why don't you come and get to know me a little bit over here? And then maybe I'll give you a favor. It's just the same as God. And that thing over here too is prayer, you see. How are you going to get to know the Godfather and you're going to ask him for favor? You cut the fucking balls to ask Godfather for the favor, you see. Without even getting to know the Godfather, know anything about the Godfather at all. You're going to go ask the Godfather now for fucking favors that you haven't eaten. He's going to tell you, who the fuck are you anyways? And not only that, but if you want to be a part of this church, you see, that I have, this mafia, you see, you got to be initiated. You got to be a made guy. You got to be a wise guy just like us over here. That's what being reborn is all about in the spirit, following the way. And if you ain't going to follow the way from my only begotten son that shows the way, you see, the head lieutenant of my organization here, we'll just call that the Holy Spirit, you see, the organization, the one that looks upon all men and makes sure that, oh, this guy, he's looking towards me, he's hearkening to my words over here, he's fearing the Godfather, then we're going to give him, make sure, and every time he asks for something, we're going to make sure his favors, we're going to give him some favor over here. That's how the Holy Spirit works. If you keep going to Godfather, say, Godfather, help me. I need a little bit of moisture over here. These fucking guys. Well, why do we go to Godfather? Remember, he's got all the power. That's why. Why do we keep going to him? Why do we keep doing that? It's because, remember, all the power, the glory, forever and ever, amen. But this secret organization, in order for us to be initiated into the mafia, into God's mafia, you see, there's ways. You got to follow the way in prayer. If I'm trying to make this a little bit simple, I'll start talking just like a fucking idiot. And I won't get so metaphysical. But either way, this Godfather now, remember, that fear. Why do they go to the Godfather? Because he's got all the power and people are terrified of the Godfather. And that's the thing too with the habitants of this oath and the things that are going to be bestowing this oath. You see, everybody's forgot about the Godfather. And he has all the power, but the things in this world, you see, these people running around and these other cliques, these other groups, these other organizations out in the material world, you know what I mean? They're doing whatever they want to do. They don't even fear the mafia. Not only that, but they don't even fear the mafia's rules. And they forgot about the Godfather in this realm over here. That's no good for the mortals. So that's Matthew 13, verse 38, when the angels are coming down to reap the harvest. Oh, because people over in here haven't been paying their taxes, you see. What happens if you don't... Now, what happens if you don't pay the Godfather your dues? Well, he's going to take your life. And it's the same severity with Godfather. If you don't believe in him, you don't follow his ways, he's just going to throw you into fucking hell. So he's got guys like us telling you the way, you see. If you don't trust and believe... And the Godfather, with all the power and glory, you see. And if you're not fucking terrified of the Godfather, just like in the Godfather movies, why do they go to the Godfather? He's got all the power because he can do all the things. That's the idea of this mafia, you see. And everybody else is terrified because they got all the power. And it's in here too as well. When the Son of God, the lieutenant here, Jesus Christ, was walking on the earth. He had these fucking demons coming up to him and foaming out the mouth. And they're terrified of the lieutenant over here. Saying, holy fuck, it's the lieutenant. Don't throw me into hell before the judgment day, you see. These fucking demons were terrified of the lieutenant over here. And they told him, the lieutenant said, shut the fuck up over there, huh? I'll do whatever the fuck I want. The master, that's, huh. See, that's the power that people kind of forgot. The authority. See, in the Gospels, the master preached with authority, you see. Why does he preach with authority? Well, because he comes from the Father of Heaven. The one with all the power, you see. The Godfather. So when the other gangs, like the demons over here, and when they seen the lieutenant, they fucking screamed and ran for their life. They were terrified of the lieutenant. The worldlings ain't, though. They ain't terrified of nothing, these fucking guys. These fucking worldlings over here forgot about the Godfather, his power, his moisture, his glory, everything. Jesus Christ is trying to lay it out in the fucking stories over here. These fucking demons, these piece of shit assholes terrifying humanity making them all fucked up in darkness over here. These fucking demons are terrified of the lieutenant. Why? Godfather has all the power to fucking kill all these pieces of shit with a fucking snap of his fingers. Just in the story with that other piece of shit forming out the fucking mouth over here with the legion of fucking demons in him. You think they were terrified of the master? Oh, please, don't fucking kill us. Don't throw us into hell before the judgment day, which everybody's forgetting about and not understanding, not realizing the fear. Well, that's because they got too much of the Netflix and chilling. They got the miserable broads. And every fucking idiot with a little fucking pecker in between his legs is just trying to satisfy some other miserable bitch in his fucking life. You don't have the fear of the Lord in him. So that's why when the lieutenant comes back, you see, to fucking collect, most of these motherfuckers haven't been in the fear of God, you see. They're going to get fucking collected, piled up, just like the parable of the fish's net. We're going to grab it all up in the fish's net. We're going to grab the fucking good ones. We're going to keep them. We're going to bring them up to the mafia. We're going to bring them up to the Godfather over here. But for the rest of you fucking mooks, you humps, not fucking doing anything over there, you fucking hump, you're going to get thrown into fucking hell. This ain't your world. You forgot who's the fucking Godfather of this organization. So that's the worldlings in a nut fucking shell. They forgot about the power, the glory, and not only that, but the plan of the Godfather, you see. And the Godfather is very severe, just like in the movies. You mess around, you fucking die. And that's the same thing with life. You mess around, you go to hell, even worse. death is nothing. Let's put it that way. As the scripture says, people are going to be begging for death. Who cares about death? What happens on the other side, you see, Godfather controls all of that. And if you if you ain't hearkening to his words, if you ain't like me, now we know why we go to the Godfather, because he has all the power for us. And not only that, but let's say the spiritual initiation now. What's that? What's that? I heard you people talking about that before too, all these fucking worldlings talking about spiritual initiation. Well, just like if you want to be a part of the church over here, God don't take no shorts. He don't take no fucking Tiny Tims. So if you can't follow the commandments, if you can't be reborn in the fucking spirit by praying, then you can't be involved in the clique, you see. It's just that easy as well. God ain't gonna take no fucking shorts. No Tiny Tims. That's spiritual initiation. Guys go through the fucking crucifixion. Why do you think I send my son down over here? To show you what the fuck spiritual initiation is gonna be like. The whole world was fighting against him. Eh? And he got fucking crucified. That's what's going to happen to you if you want to be in my church. You think God's mafia is a fucking joke? That's another thing too. Spiritual initiation. Serious. You got to go through the crucifixion. You want to be a part of the fucking game? You want to be a part of God's mafia? You want to be a part of the church? He's going to bust your fucking balls like you haven't even experienced before. Because there is no thing in mortality. So this is the invisible now. You get initiated into the invisible. You don't take no shorts, cowards. That's at the end of your revelations over here. Betrayers. Just fucking idiots. Where does it say over here? Yeah, over here. Chapter 22, Revelation, verse 15. Outside the gates here. You see, out here in the world here. Outside are the dogs, the sorcerers, the fornicators, the murderers, the idol worshippers, and all the ones who love falsehood over here. When he comes, that's the great fiery furnace. And all these fucking pieces of shit that don't have the fear of God, that don't have any knowledge about nothing, that can't follow the commandments. See, like the rules of the mafia, they have to follow Godfather. And if we don't follow Godfather, you see this whole initiation now, what do we get after we're initiated? Well, John chapter 1, just a chance to become sons of God over here, children of light. That's what it's like being in the brotherhood of Christ, in the body of Christ. Not everybody wants to be a gangster. They can't handle it. They can't hack it. They're just a bunch of fucking bitches. Wannabes. That's just like the people in the church. They're just fucking wannabe preachers. They haven't went through the initiation. They don't want to be real gangsters. So if you want to be real under Christ, you got to go through all that crucifixion. And it's real. The spiritual initiation that no one really knows about. They think they just go to fucking church over here and then go home with your miserable fucking wife and try to stuff your fucking dick down her throat. Eh? That's following God's way? I don't think so. People don't really know about initiation. It's going to take you out of material living. You understand? Just like the gangsters. You think they fucking go out to work? That's like Goodfellas. Ray Liotta at the start of Bad here. These fucking rats going over to work smelling like fucking hogs and pigs working for their fucking wives. They don't want to do that fucking shit. That's why they joined the mafia. Not everybody wants to be a fucking wise guy. It's the same thing with God. Not everybody wants to follow his ways, be initiated into the clique, and have Godfather rule over you after with all of his power, glory, and his only begotten son, the lieutenant of creation. Nah, they don't want any of that. They don't know. See, that's the thing. God keeps the mafia just like the mafia secret. You ain't going to get spiritual initiation. That's why the gospel here is... You think some fucking asshole that's been studying ancient Greek, spending 200,000 fucking miserable dollars, 50 fucking years old, 60 years old, still can't fucking read basic English. You think that cocksucker's got the fucking Holy Spirit, huh? You think God's going to give some asshole in a fucking university that's just been studying fucking shit the Holy fucking Spirit of life? That's one thing, too, that people don't realize, that this Holy Spirit is no fucking game. It's no joke. Not every human being gets the Holy Spirit. And if you want to be a part of the clique, it's pretty severe. You have to what? Deny yourself. Pick up the cross. Not everybody wants to deny themselves. They want to go to fucking work and work for the miserable wives. All right, fine. You go work for there, and we go work for here. And at the end of the day, all the other ones that don't fucking do that, they go to hell. That's what we found out. The boss is serious, especially about this day and age. But people just forgot about the clique and the power and the glory of the boss. Now, to follow people like me, see, we're just a bunch of fucking loudmouths, lieutenants, saying that we have a godfather. Yeah, we do. And so do you. Everybody's got the God. He's the godfather for a reason. Man, everybody's got him. But you have to worship the godfather. And how you worship him, you don't go to no fucking church out here in the world. You have to pray in your invisible, or basically acknowledge the invisible within you. So Matthew 6 again, shut the fucking door, shut your mouth, and pray. That's actually the simplest. You want to know the fucking simplest reason to pray to Godfather? Eh? What the fuck do you have to pray to Godfather for? It tells you Godfather knows your needs. Eh? He already knows what the fuck you need in the organization. Just shut the fuck up like a good fucking soldier, actually. You know, like one of those Britain fucking assholes that stand on guard all fucking day? Yeah, you're just gonna shut the fuck up in prayer like that. Just imagine you a soldier sitting there shutting the fuck up and waiting for me to tell you what the fuck to do. That's what it's like serving the Godfather. Eh? That's exactly what we do. We deny ourselves. Whatever Godfather reveals to us, we say thank you. And then we live with that, you see? Like when Godfather gives you an order, you carry out the orders. You don't do what you want to do afterwards, or else you're going to get fucking whacked. You think what? The Godfather tells you what to do afterwards? You're going to go do whatever you want? Eh? Who the fuck do you think? Just like the story of Jonah. Oh, I sent one of my lieutenants out there, that fucking guy Jonah. You know what he did? He went somewhere else afterwards. Yeah, he went to some ship. I told him to go over here. He, in his own mind, said, no, I'm going to go over there instead. Oh, yeah? So when he went on the ship, I crashed the fucking ship. Not only that, I made him sleep in the belly of a fucking whale for 3 days and three nights. Why? Because all the power's in me. If they don't, that's how I, the lieutenants of God, see, his prophets, if they don't do what God's doing, then God's going to fucking whack them. And that's exactly the story of Jonah. If he didn't do what God was going to command him to do, he would have found somebody else to do it. It's just that simple in the organization. If you can't follow Godfather, especially when you're not a made man yet, when you don't get that son of God, that children, if he didn't make you a made man, You're just a lieutenant, you see. And you didn't carry out orders. Oh, Mink. That's what you're going to get you fucking whacked in the organization. God's severe, you understand? It's the same thing. If you don't follow God's fucking ways, he ain't going to use you. You're John chapter 15, a branch cut off. Withers and fucking dies and gets thrown into hell, you understand? No, but no one understands the parables, you see. They need some fucking whack job like me to start fucking preaching the gospel to all the other fucking people who forgot about Godfather and all of his power and glory and all his fucking lieutenants coming back to collect from his fucking humps. Yeah. That's the parables, you see. And when he comes back trying to collect from you fucking humps that haven't been paying, what happens to the fucking humps that haven't been paying? Well, just like in Goodfellas, like when Paulie, that fucking asshole couldn't pay Paulie. Fuck you, pay me. Anyways, you don't got any money? Fuck you, pay me. What's the matter with you? Don't got this? Fuck you, pay me. It doesn't matter. I come to collect, you see? The second coming? Fuck you, pay me. What have you been doing in your life, eh? Nothing. Sitting there like a fucking hump. And when it comes around, you see, and the Lord's going to come and collect, what's he going to do? Fuck you, pay me. That's exactly what he's going to fucking do. And if you can't fucking pay, the lieutenant's going to throw you in the fucking hell where you belong. Because you couldn't actually hone up to the commandments of the fucking Godfather, you see? These pathetic people in the world don't control nothing. The Godfather controls. That's what he teaches us in the secret here, in his secret clique, his secret mafia, his choich. But you have to get initiated into the choich. This ain't just for no fucking humps over here. Just want to sit around and say they have a Godfather. And I could do that. He does whatever he wants for me. But when Godfather wants to collect from you, what happens after you? Every time these people go to the Godfather and they have to ask him for a favor, right? Yeah, sure, Godfather gives him a favor. But now you're indebted to the Godfather. Now when he wants something from you, you're going to have to do from him. That's the relationship with God over here, eh? You can't just go to God and be like, hey, do something for me, God. Oh, okay, what are you going to do for me afterwards? Nothing? God's going to demand your life. Pick up the cross. Deny yourself. Those who think they saved their life by smashing pussy like a Super Smash Brother, they're going to fucking lose it. But those who lose their lives for the sake of me and the Gospels, they're going to find it. They're going to join the clique. They're going to be a part of the game. You see? The real fucking clique. With the Godfather. But for all those that don't, see, in this universe, it ain't controlled by man. It ain't controlled by Mother Nature. It's controlled by the Godfather. And the Godfather's gonna come around and collect from these miserable fucking humps that haven't been paying. You see? That's the fucking parables. That's why it's very important to get in touch with the Godfather, you see? And beg him for mercy. It don't matter if you have to pay, because you have to pay with your life anyways. Your life is nothing. You gotta understand here. The boss threw us in darkness. And we have to beg for the light that enlightens all men to be a part of the clique. It's that easy. If not, you know what? Who's your rulers over here? Motherfucking nature. And motherfucking nature don't give a shit about nobody. That's why you see all these fucking humps dead on the street. Where's Mother Nature to help them out, huh? The sun just keeps sunning around, shining. The fucking earth keeps going around the sun. Mother Nature don't pop out of there and help these fucking mooks. Nope, they just sit around like a bunch of fucking humps anyways, doing their trank, doing their fucking wives, doing whatever. Anything. Yep. That's why they don't get it, you see? That's why I have to come out like this way and start talking like this now. Change the fucking game a little bit. Make sure people really understand that God's fucking severe, just like the fucking Godfather is in the movies. All the parables. And you know, for all those fucking humps, right? It's so easy for them to pay the Godfather a little bit of fucking respect. That's the Godfather as well. What does he respect? Fear, power, respect. They don't fucking do any of that shit. That's why they're out there in the fucking street doing nothing. Now there's a new fucking drug making people like fucking zombies. You think the Lord gives a shit about these pieces of shit, huh? No. Because they don't fucking respect God at all. They don't fear the fucking Godfather. They don't know anything about the Godfather. They don't want to know nothing about the Godfather. That's why the people are in miserable fucking conditions. Because the Godfather is the only one that can give them moisty from these conditions, but they don't want to. Who cares why? I don't give a fuck anymore. The parables are going to toss these fucking miserable humps into fucking hell where they belong, so the saints like me can start fucking shining. Instead of going out here and wanting to commit fucking random acts of violence, let's put it that way. Lucky the Lord doesn't make us into real fucking worldling gangsters. No, he makes us more into saints. We have to fucking practice forbearance a little bit. I know it tells us not to swear, but either way, the Lord says to preach for the fucking tongue of the people in their day and age, and most of the fucking people are degenerate. they have the thug gangster mentality, bruh. So good, I fucking preached to you God a fucking gangster way. And that's how God is, motherfucker. God is the ultimate motherfucking gangster. And if you don't fucking pay respect to the fucking Godfather, all you motherfuckers get tossed into hell. Because people like me are fucking tired of watching this shit earth spinning around in fucking filth. That's why. That's why the Lord's gonna fucking uproot all this bullshit. So the fucking people, the righteous, can start fucking living without this fucking shit. All you motherfucking humps doing whatever you want to do. Eh? Good. Do whatever the fuck you want to do. When the Godfather comes back and you can't fucking collect and pay like fucking Paulie, well, guess what? You're gonna get fucking whacked. And not just death. You get fucking whacked into the gates of hell. Fuck you and pay me. That's what fucking God says. Fuck you, pay me. With the fucking respect, the fucking love, and the knowledge. If not, give me a kafane. I feel your butana, de chilo.